So good morning, Mr. Kuchi, Kiran, Kumar. My first question is, what was the need to develop a new standard called low mobility, large coverage cell for India's rural population?
Okay. So the cellular base stations that we have today are mostly designed for urban deployments like cities and small towns. So the base station usually covers 200 meters cell radius. So every 200 meters you need a tower. That's not suitable for rural areas. It's very difficult to erect towers every 200 meters because there is no fiber or what is called backhaul. You need fiber going to panchayat, which is the government doing today as part of BharatNet. From the fiber termination point in a panchayat, you put a cellular tower which should serve anywhere from 5 to 10 kilometers radius where the villages are distributed. This is not something considered by global standard bodies or the global players. That's why we need to, we actually have come up with this need, which is very specific to India. Maybe it's common to other countries like, you know, Australia or Africa or other places where they have vast rural regions. This is a gap that was missing and unsolved for the last 20 years. So we had to really solve it using the LMLC concept.
My next question is, what was the role of IIT Hyderabad in developing this new technology?
Yeah, so LMLC is a concept. And in fact, this is championed by several people over many, many years. I am a professor at IIT Hyderabad. I have been developing solutions, the technical solutions required to solve the LMLC. For example, the waveform that we introduced in 5G, I talked about during this talk today. Actually, this LMLC concept is developed by Professor Bhaskar Ramamurthy, myself, Professor Radha Krishna Ganti, Professor Kluto Millet, these other gentlemen are in IIT Madras. And we actually solved this over a long period of time, and we presented this to ITU, an international body, through Government of India. So it's actually quite a collective effort between a few IITs.
Can you talk a little about how will this new technology help rural India?
Well, I think this is a major breakthrough in the sense that India will ensure that through BharatNet and LMLC compatible 5G technology will ensure that large populations of rural people will get access to wireless internet, which is basically cellular, using 5G or 4G enhancements, using low-cost solutions. And the technology that is developed by us and pushed by the government and ITU will ensure that in the coming years, products will come out cheaper than what it is today and serve the need of the rural population. Thank you.
What would be the role of IIT Hyderabad in developing 5G testbed for India? What key technologies in 5G is being focused by IIT Hyderabad?
Okay. 5G testbed is a consortium between IIT Hyderabad, IIT Madras, IIT Kanpur and a few other IITs and IISc. Specifically, IIT Hyderabad has a large role in this project where we are developing some revolutionary technologies and contributions which we want to commercialize. We are in the process of commercializing. I will name a couple of them. A new technology called Massive MIMO with nonlinear precoding has been developed, and it's a breakthrough, and we experimentally demonstrated you can increase the capacity of a cell site 12 times. 12 times is a large increase. You have to buy spectrum 12 times, and it's 12-fold increase in the cost if you have to increase capacity 12 times. But here, with one piece of spectrum, we can increase the capacity 12 times using large antennas in the cell site. This is one major contribution IIT Hyderabad is bringing. The second one is we are building a narrowband IoT chip in the testbed project, narrowband IoT chip. We will design a mass production chip at very low cost, just a few hundred rupees, and this will go into sensors and it will communicate with the base stations for smart cities. This is a major contribution from our end, from IIT Hyderabad.
Okay. IIT Hyderabad is part of High Level Forum for 5G India 2020. Can you, you know, talk about some of the 5G use cases being, you know, where IIT Hyderabad is currently working?
Yeah, so first of all, IIT Hyderabad is part of the 5G High Level Forum. In fact, Professor UB Desai, Director of IIT Hyderabad, is the prime representative in this prestigious High Level Committee, 5G Committee. We are mainly focusing on, like I just said a moment ago, bringing IoT, Internet of Things, which is also called machine-to-machine communication, where this chip that we are developing will directly connect from, let us say, a smart meter or electricity meter or a healthcare application, its embedded chip, to the cellular base station, which is basically an operator network. The technology is not here right now. Right now what we have is Wi-Fi and Bluetooth IoT, but we are talking about cellular IoT at a very low cost. This is something, you know, a major contribution for our, from IIT Hyderabad side, in addition to what we are doing base station developments for 5G base station development using massive MIMO technology and the advanced versions of it.
Since innovation will play a big role in the, you know, proliferation of 5G, so what role you see from startups, you know, contributing on this subject?
Well, at least in India, it is the government support, it is the academia, that is IITs and IISc and so on and so forth, and the startups. These are the three ingredients required to build new products for 5G and become very big major players. In fact, the 5G testbed project and the government very actively encourages Indian startups to participate in the testbed project, and this is happening. We are procuring some components of the technology from local Indian startups. And in fact, it is expected that some startups are created in the IITs as part of this 5G testbed project. And this is happening. In IIT Hyderabad, we did start a company within the university campus. And we are very actively working on commercializing some of these technology, and this is happening in other places as we speak. So we are working with existing startups, existing companies, and new companies are being brewed, incubated. And this is a very active and evolving ecosystem, and the government is fully supporting it. I think there are some good things to happen in the future.